We've recently made a decision to renegotiate on the power purchase agreements, especially these high-rate power purchase agreements. Probably slightly controversial when it comes to now speaking of a state to do something like that. But I'd just like to draw your attention to one simple aspect. What is the point in having a power purchase agreement if the DISCOMs are not in a position to pay your bills? By the time I got into the Chief Minister's post 2 months before, it's only been 2 months since I got into this seat, into this place that I am in. And by the time I had come here and I had taken a review of the DISCOMs, the electricity position there, the DISCOMs position, the officers told me that we had 20,000 crores of arrears. 20,000 crores of pending bills, arrears. The government was not paying bills for the past 1 year to 1.5 years. Then what is the point in having these PPAs? Will it add any value? Number one, it doesn't add any value. The DISCOMs are already crumbling. So what do we do? If we are to be sincere about our cause, if we are to do something about it, we need to do something about it, even though they are slightly controversial. So what we did was, you know, we need to give a win-win formula for everybody. We are trying to renegotiate. I do agree that, you know, there are international communities there, there are banks there, and we need to give them confidence as well while we renegotiate. So we're coming out with a win-win formula policy as well, where, you know, we're bringing them to reality, seeing that DISCOMs do not work like that, they cannot function like this when the revenues are lower and cost of procurement is far higher. Then no DISCOM can ever function. And the only way we can do this is to bring a sustainable model where the rates come down, where probably investment could be treated as debt with a soft loan. But these kind of innovative policies, if we don't come out with, there'll be nothing left of us to offer anybody anything.